So good morning everyone. In our last class we have looked into intensity level slicing, then we have also looked into thresholding. Okay, now today we will start with bit plane slicing. Okay, so what is a bit plane? Let's look into that first. In our image, we are dealing with 4-bit image. Okay, so our grade level values, it varies from 0 to 15. So how to represent this? Okay, for the representation of this, we have a simple formula: 1, 2, 4, 8. Right. So for 15, what it would be? It would be 1, 1, 1, 1, which would be the maximum value. This is for 15, right? For 1, what it will be? For 1, it will be 0, 0, 0, 1. So what is this? The number, this position is? क्या बोलोगे? What is this position and what is this position?
सर बाइनरी डेसिमल.
हाँ, बिट प्लेन में if it is a bit, if you are representing it in binary this thing, what is this? What is this position? This is the lowest significant bit and most significant bit. Right? So, if you so in plane terms, this position is 0th plane. This is its first bit plane. This is 0th bit plane. This is first bit plane, second bit plane, and then third bit plane. Okay. So suppose you are given with this image, all of this can be broken down into this binary number, a set of 4 binary numbers, 0, 1, in the combination of 0 and 1. If I say you that make a 0 plane image, 0 bit plane image, what you will be doing? You will be putting all these numbers, say 10. How the 10 is made? 8 plus 2, 10. So 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay? Then 7. 7 is 0, 1, 1, 1. Right? So this was for 10, this was for 7. Right? Now, in likewise, you will be getting for all this number, you will be getting such kind of digits. So, if I say you draw a 0th plane of the image, 0th bit plane of the image, so what you will do at the 0th position, whatever will be the number, you will take those number and correspondingly for 10, you are getting 0, for 7, you are getting 1. In this way, you will fill up the values. So that will be your 0th plane, 0th bit plane, sorry, 0th bit plane. Okay. Similarly, if I ask you, draw the first bit plane of this image, then under the first number, whatever the planes are there, whatever the numbers are there corresponding to your this gray level values, that you will put. Similarly, for the second bit plane and the third bit plane. Exactly. Yeah, value of the bit plane 0, 1, 2, 3. So if I say 0th bit plane, whatever the values will be there in the 0th plane, you will be putting those values corresponding to the specific gray level value. Am I clear?
Binary.
Yeah, bit place are always in the binary. Okay. So let's make this first, then we will go deeper into the thing. So first convert this image into say zeroth plane, zeroth bit plane, and the third bit plane images you draw, and intermediate you make it, but for the sake of time for now you can just skip it. Okay, now coming to this bit plane slicing. So bit plane is a one word, bit plane, and then slicing. So what does this say? We have seen what a bit plane. Then slicing means, what do you mean by slicing?
Taking a piece of
thing. So when you take a piece of thing, so what happens there? Then there is nothing. Nothing means zero. Okay, so bit plane slicing means, if I say slice the zeroth bit plane, then at this plane, at this zeroth plane, whatever the values are there, zeros will be zeros, ones will also be converted to zero. Okay, similarly if I say slice the third bit plane, then all the values in the third position, they will be put to zero, whatever the numbers. So these are binary numbers, so all the ones will be basically converted to zero. Okay, if I say slice the lowest two least significant bit, two least significant bits, then zeroth and one position, all the values will be zero. So this is say 10, so it will be basically becoming 00. This is 11, it will be becoming 00. Okay, if I say slice the two most significant bits, then at this position 2 and 3, whatever the values are there, they will become zero. For 10 it will be 00, for 7 it will be again 00. Are you getting my point? Okay, so now you do one thing, you make a table R then S when two LSB are sliced and S when two MSB are sliced. So write down 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in this fashion. You write down. Then S minus 2 LSB, you put up all the two values to zero and write the values of S. Similarly for S minus 2 MSB, this is my notation. Okay, this is my notation. You can name it in any other fashion also, but you have to you have to define that notation. Okay, whatever you are telling. So minus 2 MSB, so you will have to put all the values over there to zero and then convert it to the decimal number and then write S. R and S, they are in the decimal format, they are not in the binary format. Okay, so S and S minus 2 LSB and S minus 2 MSB, both will be decimal. So you have to suppress that and again convert it into the decimal format and then you have to write it down. Okay, so please do this task. Now after suppression of the two LSB planes, we have got this number, so correspondingly these R values has been converted to this, and here
we have got s value when two MSB bit length has been sliced or suppressed. Slicing or suppression both are same. Okay, so you may have bit length suppression or bit length slicing, both are same and they are used interchangeably. Okay, तो ये मत बोलना इफ आई गिव दैट यू ड्रॉ द इमेज आफ्टर सप्रेसिंग द टू मोस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट बिट्स देन यू डोंट टेल दैट वी हैवंट डन दिस स्लाइसिंग एंड सप्रेशन बोथ आर सेम ओके सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ओवर हियर यू सी ए ग्रुप ऑफ पिक्सल्स दे आर अज्यूमिंग सम वैल्यूज And these values, these are wide apart. These gray level values, these are wide apart. So, what is the thing? Overall dynamic range has decreased. Don't tell me dynamic range. Contrast has increased. Okay? The contrast has increased and then what? A group of pixels have been clubbed to one pixel. A group of pixel has been clubbed to one pixel. Okay, so in the original image, if there were some minute variations in the gray level values, what would happen? Now they will look, they will be having same thing. Suppose you are having say 2x2 image and you are having say 0, 1, 2, 3. Previously they were different, but now in an image it will appear as if it was a single pixel. So this is called, previously we have already discussed, this is called pixelation. So you will be having pixelation effect. In many images you will find that there are box like thing. Why they are happening? Especially when you zoom out your image, you will find this kind of effect. What is happening? Your screen resolution is very good, but when you are magnifying to such an extent, so over there when you are interpolating all the pixel values, they are assuming a group of pixel values, they are assuming a single pixel value. Okay, and because of that, you are getting this pixelation effect. Okay.
It also depends on the number of bits, right? Because
definitely, the
images have more number of boxes in comparison to
the pixels. Means I didn't get it.
For example, in the video games, that Mario triggers 8 bit, right? So that box. Now it's more the bit images.
That is there. That is always there, but. When there is a minute variation and there is a scope of doing having a separate this thing, so we are having better we will be having we will be looking into the local area and we will be having good contrast. But when you are suppressing the LSBs, you are getting what do you call it? You are getting a good contrast. There is a there is an increase in the distance between the pixel value, and then a group of pixel values, they are assuming same pixel value, so there is increase in the contrast. And then the second is your pixelation effect may occur. Okay, then next, when you go to the MSBs, if you look over here carefully, 0 is mapped to 0, 4 is mapped to 0, 8 is mapped to 0, and 12 is mapped to 0. That means the lower values, they are mapped to 0, but even the higher gray level values, they are assuming these values. The lowest significant values, the lowest value, not significant value, the lowest value. Similarly, for these other three cases also. So what is happening over here? There is many to one mapping. When there is many to one mapping, that is not giving you representative information. That means, what would happen over here? There is a loss of information. There is a loss of information, and because of the loss of information, if you suppress the most significant bits, what will happen? Since there is a loss of information, whatever the information you will be getting, all are crap information. So you cannot rely on that information. Okay? So, from here, the takeaway point is that never ever suppress the most significant bit of your images. If you want to suppress the image, if you want to reduce the noise contents, or if you want to reduce the bit planes, because when we reduce the bit planes, the variation decreases. Okay, as we have seen. Now, if the variation decreases, your entropy will decrease. And entropy is directly related to the size of your image. Okay, entropy is directly related to the size of the image. Okay, you can see over here. Previously, you are having 15. So, what is the dynamic range? 15. Now, over here, you are only having 4 values. You just have to store 4 values. So, what should be the energy? Energy should be the less. Okay? Now, since you are having lower energy to store, so energy in digital form, it is nothing but your file size. Okay? Now, since your file size is lower, the storage needed to store these images, it will also be lower. Okay. Now, another important thing is there. What about the noises we see? These noises, they mainly occur in this LSB. Because we have seen MSB, it contains information, and if you suppress that, your information is lost. Then where would be the noise logically? I am not going into the details of the thing because that is out of the scope of this course. So logically, if you think, if the information is in the most significant bits, the noise content information will be in the lowest significant bits. Okay, so all the noises, they are over here. If you want to reduce the noise, if you suppress the lowest bits, it can help you in reducing the noise content of the image. Okay, it can help you in reducing the noise content of the image. Okay. So, yep. So you can plot the histograms for both the images, S minus 2 LSB and S minus 2 MSB. Plot the histograms and compare it. Whatever I have discussed, you will find that there is an increase in the contrast, and also the pixel values these things, they have at a particular S value, it would increase. Okay. And over here, there is loss of information. Now, next is histogram processing, and over that, how to find out this cumulative and all this probability distribution function and the cumulative distribution function. I will just tell you in brief over here. We have already discussed. So you have to plot the first. You should have the gray level value, and corresponding to each gray level value, how many number of pixels are there? You find out that one. Then PDF, which is also regarded as PR, it is given by the number of pixels divided by the summation. So you will get all these values, and the summation of this should always be 1. Okay, we have already discussed. And then CDF, how will you find out? This PDF will come over here, this one, and previous to this there is nothing. In this case, what you will be having? This one plus this one. Okay, in this cell will be this one plus this one. In this cell, it will be addition of these two numbers. In this cell, it will be addition of these two numbers. In this fashion, it will go, and at 15, it will be 1. Okay. So, in our next class, we will be talking with histogram stretching. Okay. We have done the piecewise contrast enhancement, piecewise stretching, and we have already discussed over there that there might be two regions. Say over here we are having no values, over here we are having no values. So we may get this kind of profile for the stretching for this thing. This is R, this is S, and this is 0. So this is this kind of example. So this is A and this is B, and we have to stretch it in this fashion so that it becomes, in the S becomes the range of 0 and n minus 1. So tomorrow we will look into the numerical. Okay. Not tomorrow, on Monday. So thank you.